What if polar bears were introduced into the Amazonian rainforest? The Amazonian rainforest. It's the biggest rainforest on the planet. You know what it's missing? The biggest bear on the planet. And when you examine the two, you almost can't get any more opposite. You have a lush green forest that is hot and humid, and then you have the bear that is the same color as the frozen landscape, white. But what would happen if you took these essentially polar opposites and thrust them together? What would happen to polar bears and to the ecosystem of the Amazon if we took the bears and put them in this particular rainforest? Would anyone have any complaints? Would everyone even survive? Destination Amazon. Let's first take a peek at our eventual destination. See what we're getting ourselves into. See what we're getting those polar bears into. The Amazonian rainforest almost couldn't be any further away from both North and South Poles. It lies directly on the equator, but it is so huge that it spreads 5 degrees north and 15 degrees south of the equator. It also spreads as far east as the northeast coast of Brazil and as far west as central Ecuador. In addition to its location being halfway between the two poles, it's also the exact opposite climate. The Amazonian rainforest just has two seasons, the dry season and the rainy season. The dry season sees an average temperature of 82 degrees Fahrenheit, along with a relative humidity of 77%. For most places, that isn't dry at all. And for their rainy season, the temperature is still warm, but averages slightly cooler temperatures, around 78 degrees Fahrenheit, and a relative humidity of about 88%. To break it down, the Amazon is hot and humid, but it has vibrant green colors and other colors all around. It's brimming with plant life and an enormous variety of animal life. The Amazon can be a dangerous place, especially with all these different species of animals. Even the small ones can be a danger, like the poisonous frogs that live there. Even some of the fish pack a bite. The Amazon River is home to many piranha. Not to mention, there are electric eels in the water, black caimans that live in and out of the water, and the fierce, strong-jawed jaguar. The jaguar is the third largest cat in the world, the largest in all of the Americas, and one of the kings of the Amazon. He bites with a force of 1,500 psi, he runs at 50 miles per hour, and his 6-foot-long, 350-pound body is meant for ambush attacks and pouncing on large prey, taking them down in an instant. The jaguar is a scary predator, maybe the scariest in the Amazon, but would he be the scariest after we move down a new resident? 6,215 miles away. So, if we traveled about 6,215 miles north of the Amazon, we might come across some polar bears. Contrary to popular belief, you couldn't also travel the distance south of the Amazon and find polar bears. That is to say, you will find polar bears in the Arctic Circle, but not the Antarctic Circle. Polar bears only live in the Northern Hemisphere, far, far away from the Amazon, and a polar bear's habitat probably couldn't be any different from that of the Amazonian rainforest. Like we said, if you travel due north from the Amazon about 6,215 miles, you'd likely hit the Arctic Circle. And it's getting chilly already, isn't it? Polar bears live in areas across Canada, but you can also go west and find them in Alaska, again, as long as you are far enough north. You can even go east and find them in northern portions of Greenland, also the Norwegian archipelago of Svalbard, and Russia. Polar bears have even been found in the actual geographic location of the North Pole itself, although that is rare, since that's smack dab in the middle of the Arctic Ocean. The Arctic Circle is huge, spanning across the entire northern portion of the globe, so depending on where you are, the temperature can vary. But as you can imagine, it's largely cold, freezing. Certain areas in the summer can reach up to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, but we are not really expecting any days warmer than that, and we are not relying on those 50 degrees days to be appearing often. More often, you'll be experiencing temperatures below freezing, far below freezing, and that's 32 degrees Fahrenheit. There are places in Siberia that in the month of January, you can expect minus 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Yes, negative 40. So as you've guessed, there's a lot of snow and ice in these regions. Yes, you'll find polar bears on the mainland, but you will often find them right in the waters of the Arctic Ocean, and they frequent the sea ice as well. The terrain in their overall habitat changes from frozen ground to frozen water to just water, even though that water feels freezing cold. So, how do polar bears do it? How do they withstand that climate? How do they handle all those different types of terrain? The polar bear way. The reason polar bears can live in such harsh conditions that would transform any human into a two-legged ice cube is because they are built for that climate. Polar bears can withstand those freezing temperatures because they are big and have bodies adapted to the cold. The polar bear is huge. It's not only the largest bear in the world, it's the largest land predator. Big bodies mean more warmth generated, and boy is the polar bear big. The males are generally 5 feet tall at the shoulder, between 8 and 10 feet long, and will easily weigh over 1,700 pounds, sometimes even exceeding 2,000 pounds. Although they are strong and muscular bears, a large portion of their body is made up of fat. In fact, it's about half of their body weight that is fat, which helps them to keep warm. One reason is because of their diet. They eat a lot of animals rich in blubber. Blubber is basically fat, and you are what you eat. All bears eat more than just meat in their diet, having some balance between meat and other foods. But the polar bear is the most carnivorous bear in the world. The portion of their diet consisting of meat is far more than the other nears. Polar bears are technically hypercarnivores, meaning that more than 70% of their diet consists of meat. A lot of this has to do with the fact that they need that extra fat. So, animals that make the polar bear's monthly menu include many types of seals. The most common is the ringed seal, as it's fairly small and easy to take down. They also eat a lot of bearded seals and harp seals. As you can see, anything with blubber makes an excellent meal for a polar bear. They'll occasionally hunt walrus too, but typically go for the smaller and younger walruses. They've even been known to prey on smaller whales like beluga whales and narwhals. They don't eat much plant matter, but they do eat fruits such as berries when they can find them, and sometimes moss, grass, and seaweed. Though the claws aren't needed for taking down a bushel of berries, they may be used in securing a meal of seal and also for traversing the tricky and slippery terrain. And a polar bear's claws are sharp, sharper than their cousins, the brown bears. They extend about 3.75 inches from their toes, which is shorter than that of most brown bears. The polar bear's bite force, another important factor when securing a meal, is the strongest among all the bears, 1200 psi. Possibly the most impressive thing about a polar bear is its speed. They can get up to 25 miles per hour on land, even the icy land. Those shorter, sharper claws assist with that. And when they're in the water, they can swim up to 6 miles per hour, and they can go for long distances too. Living in the Arctic means you have to be an endurance champion. But is a polar bear also an adaptable champion? What would happen if we took several polar bears and brought them to the Amazon? From the Arctic to the Amazon. We finally booked that direct flight from the Arctic to the Amazon, and we have dropped off our polar bears right in the heart of the rainforest. The first thing they would notice, the heat. It's like stepping off a plane into a warmer climate and wishing you weren't wearing your jacket. Only the polar bear's jacket is his layers of fat underneath his skin, so he wouldn't be able to take them off. This would pose a major problem for the polar bears because they are adapted to living in the cold. That is why their bodies have so much fat. That much fat in their bodies would cause them to become overheated in the Amazonian rainforest. The short answer to this question, if you immediately introduced polar bears into the Amazon, it would be highly unlikely that they would survive. Though they'd be excellent hunters and would have their pick of prey, their bodies wouldn't be able to handle the extreme heats. They'd probably spend much time in the water trying to cool off, and that just wouldn't be sustainable. However, if we looked at this through a long-term lens, the polar bear may have a shot. For instance, the polar bear's cousin is the brown bear, a species of bear that is so closely related that the two can actually mate and create hybrid offspring. Now, brown bears are mainly found in cooler climates, not quite as cold as polar bears, but they're typically found throughout colder regions like Canada and northern US. Some people think brown bears don't live in warmer climates because they are not suited to it. However, historically, brown bears have existed in many warm climates. They used to live in southern US and even in Mexico. Over time, various factors have pushed them out of those places. But if various factors were to ever push brown bears south again, and over a long frame of time they made their way to the Amazon, adapting along the way, century after century, they'd be able to exist down there. So perhaps the polar bear could do the same. Polar bears would need to adapt to eating less meat, storing less fat, and they'd thin out. They'd likely shrink in size. That would be the way a polar bear could potentially make it in the Amazon, but a sudden change, it wouldn't work. And even if a polar bear thinned out and shrunk down in size, they'd still be big. They'd still be bigger than the jaguars there, and would likely keep their title of apex predator, move it from the Arctic down to the Amazon, and feast on all the fish the river had to offer, and they'd likely adapt their tastes to include many tapirs and deer and things of that nature. The jaguars would be upset with the competition, but at least they know now if this were to ever happen, it would take a long time. They have plenty of time to prepare. Again, the polar bear is too used to its extreme climates, and a sudden move to the Amazon would be too detrimental to their health. They'd slow down instantly. Their extra fat would be weighing them down, preventing them from daily tasks, making hunting a chore in most instances. The jaguars would love to see that. They may even be able to make a slow, exhausted polar bear into an exotic meal. The polar bear may outweigh the jaguar, but after some time in the humid climate and the overbearing sun, a jaguar is plenty strong enough with powerful enough jaws, able to take down a tired polar bear. But if we gave the polar bears a few thousand years to adapt and make their way down to the Amazon the long way, watch out, jaguars. That's no bear you want to see. For now, the only bear in the Amazon is the spectacled bear, and it looks like it will stay that way for a while.